Okay, we're back and have a one layer of gnome oil put on the Scientist, and we're going to go ahead and put a second on the tripod head. While we're waiting for the second coat of gnome oil to go ahead and dry, why don't we go ahead and put the first coat of bronze on. And for this, I'm just using the Vallejo bronze. I'm going ahead and pour some out here, thin it with a little bit of water. And just put our first coat on this. This probably take a couple coats too. So there we go. We got one complete coat of bronze on the faceplate. And when that dries, we can go back to adding some gnome oil. All right, we've had 4 or 5 coats of gnome oil onto the Martian tripod head, giving it that good metallic look. And we had added the brass. So our next step is we're going to add some Agrax Earthshade Gloss into the brass eye area. And go from there. Just kind of put it on heavy so it'll settle in. Let that dry. Got a little too much. Clean it off. See if people can see that. Okay. Okay. Our next step is to add some brass highlights onto the legs where the just kind of mechanical is showing. Just kind of give it a little bit of different look. I'm experimenting with making a mess, apparently. I'm experimenting with some different camera angles, so as we move through this, I'll have more idea. I'll make sure I'm not blocking everything. Now Now when these dry, I'm going to go ahead and throw a shade on them also. Not going to really show that stuff. It's not necessary. And you can see we have all three tripod legs thrown with that. Now you can kind of pick out any little areas that might look good with a brass or a highlight, like we're doing here. Just kind of to add a little bit of different look to the thing. It's up to you whether you want to do these kind of things or not. So we got all three tripod legs and all three leg indentations covered in brass. Hopefully you can see those. So our next step is to try and add some highlights. And for us to do that, we're going to use Storm Host Silver. This is a really bright, heavy pigmented paint. And we're just going to edge highlight with this. So we're just going to use a brush that's kind of long. And get some paint on. All the way up the side, like that. And I'm just going to go along the edge of the tripod head and various items to try and add a little bit of a highlight. Now, I'm not sure how much the camera is picking up this highlight, but on the table you'll see a nice difference. So we'll go around. We're going to go underneath, add a little bit of highlight to various pieces sticking out. So I do want to show, I did go ahead and make a thicker edge highlight. I had kind of went on it thicker because it really was almost impossible to see. Sometimes in the light, all the variations of silver makes it difficult. You guys can see all this. So I'm just trying to go around, just get a little bit of an edge on each of these rivets pieces. Sometimes I get a little too thick, but clean that off. Cover it up again with nice color. So, you know, I'm by all means not a perfect painter. And I'm learning a lot as I go, too. So you can see I kind of hit that gun just to put an edge on it. So I can show you guys. So tentacles kind of in the way, of course. There you go. I think we got most of the edges. Kind of almost like a little bit of a dry brush on the edge here. Like that. So there you go. Scientist. And I guess we're going to be ready for the eyes. And you see one thing I want to highlight. So next up will be the eyes. And sure.
Okay, we got the edge highlighting and the bronze highlighting done. And you can see that I've gone ahead and went back, and I didn't like just a really thin edge, so went ahead and made a larger edge. It's more distinctive around the scientists here. So our next step is we're gonna work on the eye. So, which is right here. And I just like a little three-colored eye, kind of a throwback to the, I don't know, was it the 1950s? War of the Worlds movie. So basically we're just gonna put I'll bring one in here. We're going to try and make this kind of eye, and that is using three colors. We got Soul Stone Blue, Spirit Stone Red, and Waystone Green. Now these are the Citadel Gemstone paint colors, and so we're just going to put them on there, go from there. Not a lot of work here to do that. I'm just going to try and split, draw a line and a line, and then add it. And this is going to take two coats. So I don't want to put it on super thick. Might even take more than two coats, looking at the way this is going on. It only took one on the assault tripod, but
This being metal and stuff might take more coats. So there you go, that's coat one. I don't think you need to see coat two, but basically that's the general idea. We're going to add green, blue, red, and I'll show it to you when it's done. Okay, so you can see we've got two coats on the eyes. It's looking pretty good. Just a couple more things I would do before I could call this thing finished. I want to put a little bit of color in the gun for the heat ray. For that, I'm going to use some Evil Sun Scarlet. And it's just working it into here. It really is difficult to paint while on camera. Okay. And finally, I also wanted to add a little bit of copper. So I need to get a different boom, I think. Because the problem is it's difficult enough to paint small, but when you're trying to paint, and then I keep blocking my hand in front of the tripod, so maybe we'll, as things move on, I'll try and get. So I just want to add a little bit of copper to the side of the gun. Let's see if anybody can see that. Again, to the side of the gun. And just some highlights on the on the claws, just to kind of give it a different look. So there you go, that would be our Martian scientist complete. I just have to base them. Probably going to do the basing technique I showed where get some Martian earth for him. And that's it. Thanks. I hope you enjoy this whole tutorial.